Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the Vue Dashboard Layout component. A dashboard is a visual display of multiple panels arranged on a single screen, so that several metrics can be monitored at a single glance. In this video, I am going to show you how to add the Syncfusion Vue Dashboard Layout component to a Vue app. I will also show you how to add multiple panels and configure them in a structured layout. Finally, you will see how to drag and resize the panels dynamically. I will start with the application creation process. I am going to create a Vue application using the Vue Vite command. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Vue and Node.js. I'll edit my code in Visual Studio Code and view the output in the Chrome browser. To create a project in Vue, open Visual Studio Code and type the npm create Vite at latest command and provide the app name my Vue app. Next, choose Vue as the framework and JavaScript as the variant. The Vue project is created. I navigate to the newly created Vue app and install the required dependencies using the npm install command. Now, the application is configured with default settings of a Vite project. To add the Syncfusion Vue Dashboard Layout component, install the Syncfusion Vue Layouts package using the npm install at syncfusion/ej2vue-layouts --save command. This command will install the Vue Layouts package along with its dependencies. The first thing I must do here is to register the trial license key to use Syncfusion components. I open the main.js file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To generate this license key, refer to the link in the description below. To use Syncfusion Vue components, first I open the AppView file and remove the default code. I import the dashboard layout component from the Syncfusion Vue Layouts package and register it globally along with its child directive. Inside the template tag, I add the dashboard layout component by adding the EJS dashboard layout tag. Panels are the building blocks of a dashboard. To use ePanels and ePanel tags, I need to import the panels directive and panel directive modules from the package. I add panels to it by including the ePanels tag inside the EJS dashboard layout tag. Within this tag, n number of panels can be added. Now, I am going to add only one panel. So, I add an ePanel tag with row and column properties. Finally, I add the required CSS references for the dashboard layout by importing the material theme. Save the changes and run the application using the npm run dev command. Look at the dashboard layout, it is rendered with a single panel. Next, I will show you how to add the header and content to this panel. To add a title, I set the header property to panel 1. And the content property to content of panel 1. See in the dashboard now, the panel is rendered with a header and content. Similarly, I add 3 more panels to the dashboard. To align the header and content in the panel, I override the base classes ePanelHeader and ePanelContent by setting TextAlign attribute in the style tag. See the dashboard with 4 panels. By default, panels are rendered one after the other vertically in descending order. I want to position these panels in a defined layout structure. The columns property will define the number of columns to be created in a dashboard. I want to create 3 columns here. So, I set the columns property to 3 in the EJS dashboard layout tag. Then, I need to set the columns position for each panel to render it in the desired column. For example, if I want to render a panel in the first column of the dashboard, I set its column position to 0. Since the column position value starts from 0, I set column values to 0, 1, and 2 for the first, second, and third panels, respectively. With only 3 columns created in the dashboard, I need to position the fourth panel within one of these columns. I add it to the second column by setting its value to 1. Now, look at the dashboard. Panel 1 is rendered in the first column, panels 2 and 4 are rendered in the second column, and panel 3 is in the third column. Like the column position, I can also specify the row position for each panel. I want to display panel 2 in the first row, and panel 4 in the second row. I set the row property to 0 for second panel and 1 for fourth panel. See, panel 2 is displayed in the first row, and panel 4 in the second row. Next, I will show you how to customize the width and height of panels using size X and size Y properties. These properties are used to set the width and height in terms of the number of cells. I want to increase the height of panel 1 and width of panel 4. So, I set the size Y property to 2 in panel 1, and size X property to 2 in panel 4. In the dashboard, the size of those panels is changed accordingly. Next, I will show you how to reorder panels using the drag and drop feature. Here, I drag panel 1 and drop it over panel 2. Panel 1 will push aside panel 2 without disturbing the layout structure. To disable this functionality, I set the allow dragging property to false in the EJS dashboard layout tag. Now, when I try to drag panel 2, I can't do it. Next, moving on to the resizing functionality, panels can be resized dynamically through UI interactions using the resizing handlers. By default, you cannot resize the panels. To enable the handlers, I set the allow resizing property to true. You can see the handlers for each panel when I hover over it. It allows you to resize the panels dynamically. I can also restrict resizing within a particular region. Minsize X and minsize Y are the minimum height and width values, beyond which I cannot shrink the panel size. Similarly, max size X and max size Y are the maximum height and width values beyond which I cannot stretch the panel size. I will demonstrate how to disable resizing for panel 1 and panel 4. For panel 1, I set the minsize Y to 1 and max size Y to 2. For panel 4, I set the minsize X to 1 and max size X to 2. Look at the dashboard now. I can resize the height of panel 1 only between size 1 and 2. It does not go smaller when I try to shrink it beyond size 1. I can only resize the width of panel 4 between sizes 1 and 2. When I try to stretch it beyond size 2, I am unable to. In this video, I have shown you how to add a dashboard layout component to a Vue application. I also demonstrated how to add multiple panels and configure them in a structured layout and how to drag and resize the panels dynamically. If you want to see a working example of this, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our Vue products through our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.